Sharecropper Selection.
And we're live. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to another broadcast of Shekua Radio. It's called Shekua Radio, but I'm feeling kind of alone, and I want to thank Ruben Zelstra for helping me out, because our tribe member, Francesco Robuselli, as known as Tripping Jaguar, is somewhere suffering in Bali. Why would you want to go there? Here in Amsterdam, we have such beautiful weather. Today, I've seen containers falling. I've seen people flying, cars slipping off the highway. But we are here, comfortable in our fantastic studio, Nachtlab, listening to beautiful music. At least that's what I hope. Also, one shout out to Shishani, who is now flying somewhere between Morocco and the Netherlands. And we will also make a journey around the world today. We will start in, I wouldn't say we would start in Lebanon, but we will start with a Lebanese musician, Rabea Abu Khalil, a Lebanese composer and lute player, and he also plays the flute. He was born in Beirut, but after the Civil War, or during the Civil War, he moved to Europe to pursue his musical studies and career. His music is a reunion of Middle Eastern music and jazz, two traditions where both a musical framework as well as improvisations have the very important place. We will listen to a piece called Ziryab, and Ziryab is not just a name, it's a name of a legendary entertainer at the royal court of Cordoba, Andalus. He was a musician, an astronomer, a fashion designer and a gastronomer who managed to revolutionize medieval music, lifestyle, fashion, hairstyle, furniture and even tableware. Let's listen to this ode to Ziryab by Rabea Abu Khalil.
Shekua Selection. Thank you.
Libya. We're now talking about Ahmed Fakroun. He is a musician born in the 50s in Benghazi, and his music is almost as funky as Gaddafi's wardrobe. It's influenced by Europop and French art rock. He was seen as a musical pioneer, but he had some difficulties to put his music out there. This was due to Libya's isolation, and also because neighboring country Algeria was taking all the shine with their Rai artists like Khaled and Shebmami. But it was thanks to New York DJs who found his music and who sampled it that it got into the world, and it made a big buzz on the World Wide Web. Until today, there are a lot of DJs who listen to his work, who sample his work, who find inspiration. And he was actually kind of cool with it all. He said that he love to hear a good remix of his own music as long as the copyrights were respected. This is for all the DJs out there. Respect copyrights. Ahmed Fakroun, Sneni.
Shekhar Selection.
Yeah.
I have to say that I really enjoyed this music of Ahmed Fakhroun. It was also new to me, so I'm glad to have heard it. We're moving on to another pioneer, maybe more known. His name is Brian Eno. He's a composer, musician, producer. He's a visual artist. People call him a visionary, an activist, a philosopher. But he himself, he likes to describe himself as a non-musician. Nevertheless, his pioneering work has been a major influence on the music of rock, pop, electronic music, and ambient music. We're going to listen to The Carrier, in which he sampled the voice of a Lebanese mountain singer, Dunya Yunis. Here is Brian Eno with The Carrier.
Shekhova Selection. Thank you.
صار كنا زي عرقنا كنا زي عرقنا كنا زي ولسه حافظ زي عرق دولي بعدنا خايدي مش حافظ زي أرضي مش حافظ قبي أنا أنا سجلت وعدي أما أنا سجلت سنا بادي بمنشر كذا بحبر
with the carrier. We'll carry on in another place. We'll head to Kinshasa, Congo, the place where the next band is based. We're talking about the Kasai All-Stars. This band is kind of very interesting. It's a band consisting out of members coming from five different ethnic groups. Each ethnic group has their own culture, language, and musical traditions. Some of these groups were in conflict over centuries, and they were seen as incompatible until they joined their forces. And also with another unexpected ally, they joined forces with the Belgian producer Vincent Kenis, and they formed this wonderful band. Big up for the Kasai All-Stars with Beyond the Seventh Moon.
Selection.
Shekel Selection.
Those last notes are always very important. A musician once told me that, he said, Krimaz, the middle part of the song is important, but the most important is how you begin a song and how you end a song. So, that was Kasai All Stars. We're now moving on to Britain, but a multicultural Britain. We're talking about Sea Man Day, which means dove in Calypso. Sea Man Day is a British funk group, mostly active in the 70s, and they have reunited since 2014. The founders were Steve Saipio and Patrick Patterson. I'm not sure if Steve hears me, but I'm not exactly sure how to pronounce his name. So if anybody who knows Steve or Steve himself or his relatives heard that I mispronounced his name, I'm sorry. They found the band, but they formed the band together with musicians from Guyane, Jamaica, and Saint Vincent. How I would love to be in one of those countries right now. Well, their music is a subtle, complex, deep funk style influenced by calypso rhythms, jazz, African music, American soul, and UK rock of that time. Their tracks have been sampled by musicians and groups like De La Soul, Kool Herc, and Grandmaster Flash. Until today, their music is widely sought after by DJs and funk lovers. Ladies and gentlemen, here is Sea Man Day with Dove.
Shekel Selection. Thank you. Selection.
I'm really loving the sound quality of this last recording, Simande. We're now going to Namibia. Erna Shimu and Sam Batola. Erna Shimu, she brings traditional Damara music and combines it with jazz and Latin. In a time where Namibia's musical scene was dominated by pop music, she knew how to identify and distinguish herself and pursue her niche. This lady ensured that Namibia's presence is firmly pressed on the world stage. In the song Haise Tuta, she makes a collaboration with Sam Batola, a guitar player and singer from Congo, but living in Namibia and working with many of his artists. We're listening to Haise Tuta.
Hey!
Erin Hashimu has an amazing voice, but I'm also very much surprised by Samba Tola. Wow, wow, wow. A voice from Congo. This is actually my first time of my life when I'm discovering music from Congo, and I think those people have something to be proud of. So, Erin Hashimu and Samba Tola. We're going a little bit to the north, to Algeria. Gem Ezaka. Gem is an Algerian percussionist, musician, and dancer. In 1973, he released his first opus, African Percussion, followed in 1978 by the album that will make him known as Gem Ezaka. It was a collaboration with his students at the American Cultural Center. This is also our last track of the Shekwar broadcast of today. But stay tuned, because we have an amazing set with DJ Deep Philip. For now, Gem Ezaka, Le Serpent, The Snake. Shekwar Selection. Thank you.
Shekel selection.
That was Gem Ezaka. And now we're here in the studio with Deep Philip. Welcome.
Thank you.
Deep Philip, he's going to take over the set. And I'm very curious, what have you prepared for us?
Well, you just have to wait and listen, I guess. I can say one thing. The first track is going to be a track from Drippin' Jaguar's new EP. He could not join us today here, but I've been invited by Drippin' Jaguar to come in his place. So he's enjoying, hopefully, the recording from Bali.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
Fantastic. Deep Philip, can you tell me a bit how you got into music making?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so in 2012 I bought my first controller, and for like 3 or 4 years I've been basically DJing at home. And 12 months ago or so, not even 12 months ago, I got approached for a festival in Amsterdam. It is called 24 Uur Cultuur. And from that point on, my DJ career got a big boost. I've been playing in Paris, in Tunisia, at Ade, and yeah, my last gig was at New Year's Eve for Gardens of Babylon. So yeah, I'm super excited what this year will bring. I've also started producing.
Sounds good. Many musicians or many artists or many people who do projects, they know that when you love to do something, we always tend to dedicate a lot of our energy, but music could also be a big headache. So could you tell me what keeps you going on? What motivates you most? What pushes you the most in what you do?
Mm-hmm. Well, for me, music is a universal language. I mean, we can connect with all people all around the world. It doesn't matter where you're from. I mean, everybody can understand music. And what really drives me is that, you know, when I play in a club or at a festival and I see people in front of me, they're smiling, they're dancing, they come to me, they say hello. And, you know, for me, it's an experience. It's not a one-man show, DJing. It's, you know, everybody is making the party. And yeah, for me, it's really inspiring to see many great producers from all around the world making amazing music. So yeah, last 12 months I've been exploring music from all around the world, Middle East, Africa, South America, and yeah, basically the whole experience.
Yeah, and could you say that world music, or like also non, was I do not agree with the term world music,
mm-hmm.
but could you say that the music from those places you just mentioned, do they play a big influence in what you do, or could you tell me a bit of how they influenced you?
Mm-hmm. Well, for me also, sometimes people ask me, okay, what is your favorite type of music? And I cannot really define it by a certain genre or something like that. For me, when it touches my heart, you know, when I get goosebumps and when I feel the passion of the producer in the music, this is what gets me. So it's kind of hard for me to say, okay, what type of music do I like, or you know, what really gets me. It's a feeling. It's, you know, you cannot describe it with your mind. You
yeah.
feel the music. It's like when you go to a festival, you're totally immersed in the music, in the whole experience. And for me, the beauty is that you can forget about all the daily problems and you can just enjoy, dance, and you know, connect with other people,
yeah.
create a great experience.
It's a part of the universal human experience.
Yes, for sure.
Okay,
for sure.
I think we are ready for a listen.
All right, let's do this.
It's yours.
Thank you. Thank you.
visual world is based. This knowledge changes. The imagination. We live in a special kind of space. Back I come. from two experiences on which our visual world is based. This knowledge changes the imagination. We live in a special kind of space.
Thank you. nager dans un ciel pur, balancer sur le sein des fleurs à peine écloses, s'enivrer de parfums, de lumière et d'azur, secouant jeune encore la poudre de ses ailes, s'envoler comme un souffle aux voûtes éternelles. Voilà du papillon, le destin enchanté. Il ressemble au désir qui jamais ne se pose, et sans se satisfaire, effleurant toute chose, retourne enfin au ciel, chercher la lumière.